expected we were going to have a...
Well, that's true.
All right, well, we'll get an official one before you leave, but I thought...
All right, thank you for everything.
Mr. President, Morton has been absolutely invaluable in our office, and he's been a strong, clear voice of reason and most forceful in presenting your views to all the groups with which we deal. They love him, and they will miss him. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Go ahead, that's great.
Yeah, the next thing is this over the Rosemont.
Our...
Happy to see you. I want to present you with your own copy of the Consumer Resource Handbook. And this is a how to do it for consumers. And $1.5 million go out to every... And we are able to do it for free. And each of your cabinet officers have donated some to pay for the printing. And you notice up here, we tell people how to complain properly. And also, we have here a listing of over 600 major companies who have their own consumer offices, so that we're not trying to solve these little problems. They are. Of course, we do list the state and the federal offices.
Well, thank you. I think this is probably the most cost-effective service for the people who are rendering.
I hope so. I hope so. That was the purpose of it. Could I impose upon you to autograph this one for me?
Yes.
This one gets framed in our office, Mr. President.
Right. Do you personally or just me?
Well, your name would be wonderful. To me, would be great. This becomes an heirloom. This Virginia would be wonderful.
You know what? I'm going to get my glasses on so I can do this right. I just wondered why I wasn't able to see what I was doing here.
Could we have a picture right over here? Would be great.
As you know, this is the President's Council on Integrity and Efficiency, and one of the highest ratings that the administration and your leadership gets is you're fighting fraud, waste, and abuse. And I think Dick Werthelin will show within the polls that it is appreciated across the country. Well, this is the group that's leading your charge. This is $31 billion that they've given you since we've started this exercise, and they just increased their contribution, if you want to call it, to your fight on this thing by 50% in the last 6 month period of time.
That's great.
They're doing a tremendous job. Scott Dempsey, as you remember, went on ahead and made the presentation, so I won't repeat that. But anyway, this is a group, and they're here to sit down there, and this is a formal presentation to you, Mr. President.
Well, thank you very much, and thank all of you. It's a fine way to start the new year. I couldn't be more pleased with the job that the Inspector Generals are doing in the continuing battle against waste, fraud, and abuse in federal operations. I was so impressed with the report at the Cabinet Council of what has been done that I asked for this meeting to meet with you personally and be able to say to you how grateful I am. And the progress report that you've just given me, I know, tells me several things. First, that you have successfully identified the best methods to detect waste, as evidenced by your impressive numbers. And second, by concentrating on the preventing problems before they occur, you've charted a course for us. By using modern technological tools and creatively applying older ones, you're bringing the best of all solutions to bear on the problem. Finally, your progress is a strong indication that the IG community cares about the quality of government which serves the American people. Dedicated, capable men and women like yourselves can make a difference in upgrading the integrity and efficiency of government and in the perception the American people have of that government. Just as important as dollar savings is the contribution that you've made toward restoring public confidence in the institution of government and his public servants. And again, you all have my congratulations and appreciation for achieving remarkable results, magnificent results over these past 2.5 years. Not only do you have the satisfaction of knowing that your accomplishments will last through this generation, but that future generations as well will benefit from a government that's more responsive to the need of its citizens. I could go on and on, but it would all be saying the same thing. Thank you for what you've done. And I understand we're going to have a chance to individually have some pictures taken here, and I'm looking forward to that.
That's true. Joe Wells, DOT. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Paul Trastrader.
Good to see you.
Thank you. I'm Dick Mulder from Dallas. I'm the interior. Thanks for being here. It's a pleasure. It's pleased to meet with you.
Joe Sankin. Joe Sankin.
Well, thank you for your time.
I'm John Martin from EPA. Mr. President. Go work his house.
That's close now. 30 miles downstream. I used to live there.
I'm Frank's
not told better. Thank you, sir.
Bill Benson, Justice. Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Mr. President, Jim Richards from Energy. Don Hodell sends his best.
I'll see him and give him back.
Yeah. Ryan Hamill, Marvin Label.
Dick Kusser, Health and Human Services.
Nice to see you.
Thank you, sir.
President Chuck Dempsey.
We'll do better in 6 months.
President Harry Weissman,
nice to see you.
Sherman Funk is coming. Last time you said,
our bite's much worse than our bark.
Okay, gentlemen, second, yeah, just move up to the left so we can see your face. Big smile now. Thank you.
Thank you. Smile again. Thank all of you. See, I can tell you so you can't take my picture when I'm telling you. All these group pictures. I'm about to tell you back in Hollywood days, Frederick March. He was very impressive looking at the time. Group pictures of stars caught any place. He would always insist on getting over that in. Now, most people think that the moon's the place to be. Someone once asked him, Fred, he said, well, no one ever reads that little caption. He was a genius at just as the front was coming down on the button. He would go, ah! The result of him with a big broad smile and everybody else. Just keep on making them unhappy.
Thanks, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. President.
I'm going to come in here without saying something. I'm Sorry that I'm late, but Dave wanted to make a few changes in my remarks.
And the changes always came late.
Dave, this is a bittersweet moment for me. I'm happy that you're going on to new and exciting opportunities. We're going to miss you. These 3 years, this man has served with creativity and skill and dedication. And I know that your work has helped convey our philosophy and the policies of this administration, not only to the people of this country, but abroad. And I'm most grateful for that. Your understanding of the modern media, your skills as a writer, your advocacy of open government and good relations with the press, I think have played a vital role in our administration. Your letter of resignation mentioned a love of the institution of the presidency, and that's exactly the way it should be considered. It is an institution that some of us only get to custody of it temporarily. But you've served under three administrations, and you've not only served that institution of the presidency, but you've served your country, served it very well. Nancy and I know how much sacrifice that these 3 years have meant to you and Ann and your son and daughter. And so we just want you to know that you go with our heartfelt thanks, and to you and your family, we wish you the best in the years to come. Now at Harvard, I won't ask you to do anything so abnormal as to converting them to Republicanism.
Hear, hear.
Just ask one thing. Could you persuade them to be tolerant of us? But anyway, God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you, particular, Mr. President. You're, as always, you are extremely kind and generous in your remarks and your thoughts. If I might say so, sir, 3 years ago, I came here, as did many others in this room, because we were convinced that there was nothing more important than that you succeed. It seemed to all of us that you faced an awesome task, and that was to rescue both this country and the presidency from perilous decline. I think all of us vividly remember the late 1970s, when our economy was in a shambles. I think you called it the worst mess since the Great Depression in one of your maiden speeches. We were adrift internationally, we were uncertain of our values, and worst of all, there seemed to be a real doubt in this country whether we could govern ourselves any longer. It was at the end of the last administration that the general counsel of that White House was lamenting that what we needed in this country in order to govern well was a total overhaul of our governmental system along the parliamentary lines. Well, in my view, the tasks and the needs of the next few years are very large still, and there's an awful lot of work to be done here in the next 5 years in the White House, sir. But I have to say that in these last 3 years, I think what you've really demonstrated is that what we needed in this country was not a change of the Constitution, but a change of leadership. In just a little over 3 years, you really have helped to restore that to health, both the country and the presidency. And I just have to say, I'm very proud to have had a chance to serve here and to learn from you during these past 3 years. As an individual, as a staff member, I want to thank you for what you've done for me. And as a citizen, I want to thank you for what you're doing for all of us. If I could just follow in the footsteps of someone who served you extremely well, Ken Duberstein, when he was here for his farewell, took that opportunity to thank some others who had been terribly important and meaningful to him during that time. I wanted to thank a few people here, if I might, because they've been so helpful to me. And first of all, my special thanks to our Chief of Staff, Jim Baker, who recruited me here and has been a steadfast source of support and inspiration these last 3 years. I think history will record that Jim Baker is the finest Chief of Staff in the modern times. I think that's a real tribute to him. I would also like to thank the many people in this room, friends in the White House, outside the White House and the departments, and far beyond, who've been so helpful, in, both on a professional basis and on a basis of friendship during this time. If I might, I would like to say a word too about some of the people I think are the real pillars of this place. Nell Yates, who keeps our, helps to keep things running out here. Ruth Henry, who is head of our telephone operators unit. Ali is here, I think, representing the messenger somewhere. There are so many, George Saunders is here. There are so many people that I think really do help to keep the White House running year in, year out. And that you really don't know how much you appreciate them until it comes time to say farewell. Finally, let me mention two other groups. First of all, those who have worked with me on staff, as part of my staff. Mike, and Pam, and Karna, Kathy, and Alden, Debbie, who came up here from Texas. So many others, Ben, and so many others, I'm sure Barbara, who's here with her husband, who's been serving me here at night, and many others, that you really have, Mr. President, a group of people who I leave behind very proudly because they are extraordinarily devoted to you, sir, and they will, I think, perform very, very well in the coming months, which is so important. And to be sure, I would also like to say a word of personal thanks to members of my family. My mother and sister-in-law have come here from North Carolina today, my brother and sister-in-law have come from Pennsylvania, and my wife Ann and our children Catherine and Christopher trundled in from McLean through the snows. You know, working here in the White House, one of the things that happens is that the families seem to pay most of the price and share very little of the glory. And I just wanted to take this opportunity to say how much their love and support has meant to me these last 3 years. Well, a thousand thanks to you all, and I tend to show up here like a bad penny, so I won't say goodbye. But au revoir until we see each other again.